Welcome, everyone. Here it is at long last. It's the start of the NBA regular season. I know everyone's just as excited as we are here on 2K Sports to get things underway. And tonight, we'll see the Indiana Pacers as they go up against the Washington Wizards. Hi, everyone. Here with analysts Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce, our reporter. Allie, take it away.
The Pacers roster has really shifted. Coach Rick Carlisle said, quote, whatever players are presented to me, I love the challenge of molding that group into the right system. This is a team where it's a strength in numbers type of situation. Brian, he says there has to be certain balance in their approach.
A lot of capable players, Allie. Thanks for that. Well, Grant, everyone is excited for this season opening contest. That includes the fans, but even more so the players.
Well, there's nothing like a season opening contest. Yeah, both teams would love to kick things off with a big win. So expect to see them giving their all on the floor here tonight.
And now the Washington Wizards starters. At the 2 and the 3 are Beal and Avdija. In the middle, it's Porzingis with Kuzma by his side. And it's Wright in at the 1. And for Indiana, Halliburton at point next to Dorte. They're the backcourt. Buddy Hield is out there with Jalen Smith. And it's Turner in at the 5, roaming the paint. It's Avdija on the wing, guarded by Hield. It's Avdija on the wing. Shot clock at 5. Over Hield. And the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Coaches loathe empty possessions. You got to be able to hit the easy ones.
Oh, got that bucket in no time at all.
That's one of the things his coaches have encouraged him to do. Look for the mid-range jumper, Tyrese. Way to knock it down.
Pass to Kuzma. Here's Wright. Here's Avdija. Rebounded by Hield. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Pass to Turner. And Wright with the defensive effort.
Everything right except the finish. Have to keep focused all the way through the play. And Bradley Beal getting a huge contract this summer. Now, he committed to being with the Wizards for his prime. And there was some speculation he might leave, but he cemented his time in Washington for many years to come.
Throw drops for Beal. The Pacers were involved in one of the biggest trades of last season, Clark, sending Domantas Sabonis to Sacramento for Tyrese Halliburton.
Tell you what, it gives Indiana one of the most exciting young players in the NBA, B.A., and I think the sky's the limit for this kid, Tyrese Halliburton. He's got all the skill set that you want in the point guard position, and in addition to that, he's a galvanizer. He's a connector. He's a leader, and that could serve the small market Pacers extremely well.
Now here's Hield. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Personal foul.
Kristaps Porzingis picks one up.
A prolific scorer dating back to his college days. Hield just understands how to generate points.
Shooting 2.
That's good from Hield. Last season, Washington was hot out of the gates. They started 10-3, but things did not end well.
You know, and after that hot start, B.A., a 25-44 ending for the Wizards, failing to make the play-in game as well. Just a disappointing season after the promise Washington showed early.
Hield hits them both.
Look, for the Pacers, I'm part of that franchise's history, so I understand the reality of being a small market team. Likely they don't sign a KD or LeBron in free agency. They've had to build through the draft and make good trades, and I don't have any doubt that they'll be able to do that because they've got some good young pieces. And are looking good for the future.
And here are the Pacers now. Pass to Smith. About 2 minutes gone by in the first quarter. The offensive rebound. That one's good for two.
Boy, how about the determination of Turner? I mean, he's a wrecking ball on the glass on both ends of the floor. Just doesn't give up on plays.
Now here's Beal. Uses the glass to finish the layup. And Clark, for teams outside of the major markets, as you said, they have to nail the draft.
Big time. That's a key component, B.A. And you've got to win a trade or two as well. I mean, that's how you build a team in most small markets. The Bucks just won a title, so we know it can be done. That's the great thing about the NBA. If you build it right, you're going to have a shot. But you got to get a little lucky, too.
Pass to Wright. Back to Beal. Here's Avdija. Let's go with a three. Offensive rebound. Kuzma. Count it. One for one to start the game.
Active hands and really good energy pursuing the pumpkin there. Great hustle by Kuzma.
Here's Duarte. Pass to Turner. Here's Duarte. Hounded by Beal. Five on the clock. Takes a 13-footer. He can't hit that time.
I don't know if you can credit the defense for that. It was just a missed opportunity.
Here's Avdija. Outside Porzingis. And there are the Wizards with another bucket.
I think you've got to run Porzingis off of his shots. I mean, you can't let him get comfortable because he'll knock him down.
Pass to Duarte. And the layup is good off the glass.
Using his speed advantage to create the separation he needs for the shot.
Right outside. Now here's Beal. Here's Avdija. Pass to Wright. Jacks up a three. It's rebounded by Indiana. Their first look at this year's Washington squad.
They ran away with this season series last year. It was one of the few teams they could beat.
And I think that's where it starts, guys. Neither team a playoff factor. But you work your way up the ladder team by team. And this is really one matchup they feel very confident with.
He's been off this whole period, unable to sustain any kind of consistency.
Kuzma, right side. Outside heel. Takes the three. Nice start for him. Sinking his first shot.
This is his shot. The defense must chase heel off that three-point line.
Right, the pass to Kuzma. And again, Washington, no good.
The defensive breakdown gives him a wide open look, but he can't take advantage.
Oh, wasted no time on that one. Heald's got 7 points in the game.
He's somebody that's really comfortable carrying the offensive load.
Beal outside. Smith against Kuzma. Right, the open look. Cans it with nobody near him. Indiana's gone 1-2 from three-point land so far. Pass to Smith. The three ball. No good there. Now Washington takes it the other way. To the inside. Here's Kuzma. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Kuzma not only has great skill, but his balance is so good. Even when he gets bumped around, he still finds a way to score.
Well, the 27th pick in 2017, Kyle Kuzma made first-team All-Rookie. He was displaying just sort of significantly better shooting in the pros than he did in college at Utah.
Jackson, he's checked in for Indiana. McConnell comes in for Duarte. Well, you look at Kuzma's shooting percentages. His rookie season, still his most efficient, Graham.
Yeah, B.A. I mean, he stayed at about that same level. But as an offensive-minded player, if he can progress a little, that would certainly help his value.
Beal gets the bucket.
Leaving folks open around Barton is a no-no. He'll torch you whenever you do that.
Outside heel. Pass to Turner to stop the run. And that's 2 points on the layup. Turner's got his second basket on the night.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Now here's Barton. Back to Beal. Count it. All three of his attempts have gone in.
We all know Beal might be a shorter off guard at 6'3", but Bradley has heart. He plays way bigger than that listed height.
McConnell against Morris. Halliburton outside. And he lobs it up to the rim. Oh, and a nice defensive play to disrupt the lob. Stolen by Jackson. McConnell against Kuzma. McConnell passes to Hield. Back to McConnell. Pass to Hield. Barton with a steal. Deflected. Here's Halliburton. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
The ideal guard in today's NBA. Tyrese Halliburton has length at 6'5". Now, he can run the offense. Plus, Tyrese is an excellent three-point shooter.
And with Halliburton, the stats show a complete guard, Grant.
Yeah. I mean, think about this. 40% from deep. Halliburton's been top 10 in the league in assists. Defensively, just racking up steals. Tyrese can play the one through three. He does just about everything.
And he makes a first.
I tell you, one of the things I've noticed about Halliburton is his endurance, man. It is off the charts. He's always pushing the pace and really outworking other guys most of the time. He's constantly revving up the motor and taking things up a notch.
Mataze's checked in for Turner. Gafford, he's checked in for Washington. Hachimura comes in for Kuzma. And that's good as he hits both shots.
Tyrese Halliburton is more like what you're seeing from guards these days. He's a tall guard with good size who can knock down the three and do damage as a slasher in the lane in addition to setting up his teammates.
Barton, the pass to Beal. Washington gets it back. And the foul on the shot. So he'll take two from the free throw line. And now a look back at last year's top shooting teams in the NBA. Washington in fifth.
They were so consistent with their shooting. Maybe not lights out, but they played smart and didn't let good looks go to waste.
Free throw, no good. Then Clark Halliburton had a great second year.
Yeah, he sure did, despite being moved near the trading deadline. I mean, improved his scoring, rebounding, and assist numbers across the board, B.A., and that's, for a really young player, I bet this guy's going to be one we're going to hear a lot about in the seasons to come.
And the second free throw is good. The Pacers have got half their attempts to go. 6 of 12. Halliburton outside. Back to McConnell. Oh, he misses the go-ahead basket. Washington's gone 0 for 3 from downtown. Barton, a good look. And again, Washington, no good. Indiana trailing here. Pass to McConnell. Here's Jackson. Here's Mataze. Barton with a steal. Morris outside to the paint. Oh, and Jackson with the block. And as it goes out of bounds, Washington able to keep possession. And that shot was going nowhere thanks to that aggressive swat.
You can almost feel the mindset he has. I mean, when the game's this close, he's going to bring it at that end of the floor.
Beal's got room. His fourth make in five tries. Solid start for him.
Well, you got to be in awe of what he's doing this quarter, actually destroying the opponent.
Halliburton, the pass to McConnell. Back to Halliburton. Kicks it out to Jackson. Clock at six. Here's Hield. Releases from the wing and drills it. Hield's got his third bucket of the night.
And this is what Hield is out here to do. To score and to do it in many ways.
Morris outside. Beal outside. Three-pointer. Rebounded by Hield. The Pacers have gone 7-14 and looking in control. With the 10-footer, drained it for 2 points. Hield's got 11.
You know, throughout this quarter, guys, they've had no answer for him defensively. And he's been absolutely relentless. 2 minutes.
Morris outside. Hield against Barton. Oh, and Jackson with the defensive effort. Indiana leading. From the wing. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Halliburton's got his second basket.
Talk about confidence. Halliburton oozing with it. No hesitation off the catch and shoot there.
Pass to Gafford. Now here's Beal. Defended by Halliburton. Oh, they get a hand on it. Hield on the wing. 11 points in the game. Fires in the triple. All right, guys, what do you think about the hustle stats for the Pacers?
Well, you know, they've been aggressive on the defensive end, and it's paying off for them. Quite a few takeaways for them in the early going.
And also, the coaching staff has to love the hustle so far. Just playing with great energy, getting out and converting in transition.
It's been an ugly quarter for him.
Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills.
There's 39 seconds left in the first quarter here. And Gafford with the block. And it goes out of bounds. That went off Gafford. Brissett checked in for Indiana.
O'Shea Brissett.
Thirty-six seconds left to play in the first. Six on the shot clock. Here's Hield. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
Now, you can't be too aggressive guarding Hield because he will bait you into fouling him and still make it.
At the line for Indiana, Buddy Hield. One shot.
One shot.
You know, the Wizards really came up short last season on the defensive end. They consistently struggled to get stops, which makes it twice as hard to win games.
Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. McConnell against Barton. Right side heel. To the wing, right side. From 20 feet. And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
They've shown so much energy right from the start, particularly on the offensive end.
I'll tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with tons blazing.
And so it's the Indiana Pacers. They lead by 11 as the quarter comes to a close. They've been aggressive in transition and find themselves in front. And don't go far. We'll be right back.
Here comes Indiana Pacemaker.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. Quite a position here for the Pacers to be in. What do you guys think?
Great offensive energy in that period. They're clearly on a mission.
Yeah, I agree. That was a flawless offensive performance so far. I mean, the shots have been falling. They're making good decisions. That's a nice recipe there.
Indiana shooting about 60% for the game. All right, this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting in the second. Hachimura and Porzingis play together up front. DeLon Wright is out there with Monte Morris. And it's Avdija in at the three, small forward. Here's Morris. The Pacers making their last shot. Inside. And Avdija with the basket on the assist from Morris. Avdija's gotten his first bucket of the night.
Good execution. They're getting some short-range looks here.
McConnell finds Hill. Right outside. Over McConnell. Misses off the right iron.
Well, guys, they need to do something to reduce this deficit. We'll see if that's the answer.
Blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup.
And despite the height disadvantage, oh my, he just attacks that interior.
You know what, guys, honestly, I didn't think he'd win that battle. I mean, that's a lot of height to give up.
Now here's Porzingis. A good-looking shot from the wing.
That is room service delivery from right there. For the sweet nine to create a high-percentage shot.
Right against McConnell to the middle. Here's Turner and Porzingis with the block. Morris left side. And count that. 2 points and a chance for one more at the line.
Such confidence as a passer. He hits guys in stride and makes it look easy. And for the Pacers, things had gotten stale. So they bring in a new coach in Rick Carlisle, a new potential star in Tyrese Halliburton, a fresh start for this franchise.
The Wizards making a switch here. Kuzma's checked in. Indiana switching things up recently, going forward in a new direction.
You know, B.A., change can be a good thing. Sometimes organizations can get comfortable winning 42, 44 games, losing in the first round. But the Pacers clearly want more. And you know what? I respect that.
Washington trailing. Down low. And he dunks it. What a pass to set him up.
What a finish. I mean, he just took over himself.
What a show of power right there from the point guard. Man, sweet.
And you know, guys, when your point guard is making explosive plays at the rim, I really do think it sets the tone for the rest of the team.
And here are the Pacers now. The Wizards making their last shot. And the shot's good. Hield's got 21 points in the game.
Really good to see Turner find the open man, proving once again he's a team first guy.
Right outside. Kuzma up top. Morris outside. Hits the trifecta. Morris has got 6 points.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks a lot. Well, Brian, the Wizards have been aggressively reshaping their roster. What they haven't done is tear it down and start a rebuild. That's often the most popular route for teams stuck in the middle, but the Wizards seem to be hoping they can catch lightning in a bottle. Back to you.
Now, no appetite for the restart, Allie. Thanks. Well, you ask any team executive, they're all looking for the next Giannis. The problem is there aren't many like Giannis.
That is so true, B.A. Good luck with that, team executives. But reality, look, with the way the NBA game has evolved, positionless basketball is what it's all about. You combine that with size, skill, and talent, that's a dangerous combination, and that's what every team needs.
Please give a big round of
Smith, he's checked in 4%.
Pacers Youth Dance Team. Give them a huge hand. That was your Pacers Youth.
Now, for those joining us now, we're in the second quarter, about 3 minutes gone by. Pass to Duarte. to the inside. Heald. Rebound, Washington.
That's a rarity for him, especially against the soft defense.
Here's Avdija. Over Heald. Avdija can't get it to go.
Probably not the shot they had in mind. But you can't fault him. He had a clean look.
And it's Heald. That time, all the assists from McConnell. Heald's got 7 points here in the quarter. Morris passes to Porzingis. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, back to Avdija. Shot clock at 6. From 6 feet away. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. And they'll give that one to Miles Turner. And 6'9", Denny Avdija, with great size for a wing, Grant.
Yeah, B.A. And you combine that with his motor, too. I mean, he's already an excellent defender with the versatility to cover inside and out.
He misses the free throw. Good on the second one. Indiana has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. McConnell against Wright. Pass to McConnell. Back to Heal. Here's Duarte. 6 to shoot. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Second personal foul.
Clark, what you like about Chris Duarte is that he can fill it up in a hurry. He's such a gifted scorer.
He really is, and he's fearless, and he's confident, and those are qualities all good scorers have. And when he knocks down a couple of shots, he can really get it going. He can get his own shot. He can make tough shots. He's a bona fide bucket getter.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he drops the first. The Pacers making a switch here. Jackson is checked in. Both good from the line that time. Well, we often see teams make big moves right before the trade deadline. Clark, do you like when a team goes through significant changes mid-season?
Well, it does keep things interesting, but as a general rule, I don't think you can do that consistently. But it does add some life and excitement to what's going on when it does happen. But major roster changes, as a general principle, are typically not going to work in your favor.
And that's just nasty right there, guys. He has a tremendous crossover.
Morris passes to Wright. Back to Morris. Kuzma outside. No good with the triple. The Pacers have gotten 5 of 7 shots to fall in the second. Pass to Duarte. Outside heel. The three is up. And again, it's Indiana with a 3.
Yeah, no hesitation from the veteran Heald. A dangerous score in these catch-and-shoot situations.
Now here's Wright. Morris outside. To the paint. Can they get it? And Kuzma with the lay-in. Kuzma's gotten his 3rd basket of the night.
Even when Kuzma is defended well, he's still great at maintaining his composure and getting to the basket.
Timeout called. The Pacers And as we head into this break, the players have an opportunity to replenish their energy with Gatorade as they prepare to go into the final stages of this ballgame.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, not to mention over the course of a season, you have to stay hydrated. If you don't, it's amazing how much slower your body is to bounce back. It can have a serious effect on performance, no question.
For Indiana. McConnell with it. Halliburton outside. Pass to Jackson. Shot clock at 6. Over Porzingis. And it's good. Off the back rim and in. And the Pacers lead by 14.
Their success from mid-range has really set them apart today.
Simply taking advantage of what the defense has given them, and they've really made the most of it.
It's Kuzma with the miss. For Indiana, they've gotten 7 of 10 attempts to drop in the second quarter. Here's Halliburton. Oh, it's blocked by Porzingis.
When a guy has a 7'6" wingspan like Porzingis does, it's just tough to get away from him or get by him. That allows him to block a lot of shots.
Now here's Morris. 6 points for him. Wright finds Morris. Oh, and Jackson with the block. Wright against McConnell. Pass to Halliburton. Here's Duarte. Jackson on the wing. Wright with a steal. And the Wizards on the break. The Pacers pull it in. They'll face the Spurs at home after this one. And that'll put them halfway through a 3-game homestand. And here's Jackson. Here's Duarte. Pass to Smith. Just 5 on the clock. Wide open, but he couldn't capitalize.
Total breakdown from the defense there. I mean, he'll usually take advantage when that's the case.
Indiana's gone 2 for 2 from the arc here in the second. And he lobs it up, and the dunk by Jackson.
Halliburton all about getting his teammates open looks. Does such a great job with his unselfishness making the pass.
Now a timeout called by Washington.
Yeah, they're hoping to turn things around with this timeout.
Yeah, you know, they had to do something, anything to stop this run. You can't just let it go on any longer.
Matase's checked in for Smith. Washington has gone 1 of 2 from deep in the second quarter. Beal outside. Pass to Barton. Outside Porzingis. Morris for three. He drops it from range. Morris has got nine.
Yep, you know, after a scoreless first period, he's really turned it up a notch, building some momentum.
Halliburton on the wing, hounded by Beal. Count it. Batadze's got his first points of the night.
Halliburton has such a really good feel for the game. He knows exactly how to get his guys to step up.
Barton outside. He hits the back iron and sinks it.
Nice job by Barton that time using the pick and roll. He's somebody that you can depend on to make solid decisions.
Here's Duarte. McConnell passes to Halliburton. Pass to Jackson. Six on the shot clock. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Hachimura's checked in for Washington. The Wizards have gone 8 of 15 in the second. The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
Great activity level on the boards. Impressive. Wow.
McConnell passes to Halliburton. Back to McConnell. Jackson against Gafford. McConnell outside. And Bradley Beal is going to pick up the foul. That'll be a second foul of the game.
These calls can be so difficult for officials to make.
Yeah, but in this case, I think you got it right. I mean, the defender was still moving there and never really had good legal guarding position. He wasn't set.
The Pacers making a switch here. Brissett's checked in. Here's McConnell. Not going to go that time. Great D that time from Porzingis. From deep, Barton. Another shot. And the bucket is good from Porzingis in deep. Porzingis has gotten four this quarter.
Dominant play from Porzingis on the glass, securing the ball and finishing the play strong.
Stolen by Gafford. It's stolen by Halliburton.
Washington foul. Will Barton. First personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for the Pacers, Goga Batadze, two shots.
Shooting two.
That free throw misses. He sinks the second. Washington has gone 2 of 4 from the perimeter in the second so far. That's tipped. Here's the break.
Nice job by Halliburton, showing you the toughness that time, going right into that defense and drawing the foul.
Fourth team foul. At the line for the Pacers, Tyrese Halliburton, two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And both free throws good for Halliburton. Minute 32 left in the second quarter. Pass to Barton. Back to Gafford. Hachimura outside. Just five to shoot. Now Porzingis. Goes up from the block.
Second personal foul.
Turner, he's checked in for Indiana. Heald comes in for McConnell.
For your Pacers, Miles Turner, Buddy Heald.
Indiana's gone 4 of 6 from three-point range thus far. Pass to Duarte. There's 57 seconds left in the first half. Hits a three-pointer. Heald's got 30 points.
Capable of lighting it up any given night. Heald's offensive game is only getting better.
Beal, the pass to Barton. Pass to Gafford. Three-pointer, Beal. It's rebounded by Indiana. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Beal against Halliburton. Soft touch off the glass. Halliburton's got 10 points in the game.
He's such a creative scorer in close. Tyrese Halliburton only needs a sliver of space to make you pay.
And another miss by Washington. Outside heel. From deep three-point range. Oh, he got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. Buddy Heald has been leading the charge for the Pacers. He's been an offensive force. Now with over 30 points after the quarter. All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Pacers Youth Dance Team.
Well, I'm here with Coach Rick Carlisle. A hot start. Coach, what did you like about this team's execution offensively?
We were making some shots. We moved the ball well at times. You've got to be careful about having the ball stick when they're doing their switching.
Good luck with the ball movement in the second half. Thanks, Coach.
Appreciate it, Allie. And we'll be coming right back after this break, ready for the third quarter.
Please give a big round of applause.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly in the second. Boy, Buddy Heald displaying all his skills today.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. Halliburton at point next to Duarte. They're the backcourt. Smith out there with Miles Turner. And it's Heald in at the small forward position. That's the group for Rick Carlisle, getting going here in the second half. And that one's good. Halliburton's got 12 points in the game.
Halliburton in his bag for sure right now, showing you everything he's got, including the soft touch.
Here's Wright. Banked it in off the glass.
It doesn't get any easier than that. The defense has to play better.
Pass to Duarte. Rebound by the Wizards. Porzingis has got 5 rebounds in the game. And early in his career, Porzingis was a shot creator. You think he can get back to that, Grant?
You know, B.A., yeah. In Dallas, his role was more catch and shoot. So it'll be interesting to see in a different system how active a role KP can fill, especially going to work inside.
Pass to Duarte. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Here's Smith. The rebound by the Wizards. Kuzma's got 4 rebounds now. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window. 9 points in the game.
So far, so good to begin this half. They're 3 for 3. Perfect.
Outside heel. Back to Halliburton. Shoots. Rebound, Washington.
Well, you know he wants that one back. I mean, more often than not, he'll sink that mid-range jumper.
And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
And look at this. This summer, a 5-year extension for Bradley Beal. One of the richest contracts in NBA history. Over $240 million.
Taking 2 shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Can't get the first one, and he's certainly elite. But does it surprise you that Bradley Beal has one of the biggest contracts in the NBA, Grant?
And that's just how it works. I mean, give it a few years, and all the stars will be paid the same. That said, it must be nice. Those are some big checks.
He does not get the second one.
You don't see him have too many of those trips to the line.
Here's Halliburton, and he trains the quick shot. Halliburton's got 14.
He's getting it done offensively, making winning plays at every turn.
Here's an 8-footer. It's wide right, hits off the rim.
This offense's first miss after 3 straight makes to start the second half.
Knocked loose. And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here. And it's time to take another look at that powerful block.
Yeah, I love that they maintain the defensive energy even when they're behind.
Here's Turner. Pass to Duarte. And stolen by Porzingis. Here's Avdija. Turner covers. And here's Beal. Right on the left side. Back to Beal. Here's Avdija. Clock at 6. Over Turner. Avdija. Good. Avdija's got his second basket of the night.
They're on fire right now. Shooting 80% to start the second half.
Smith outside. Releases. Bradley Beal puts it in. The Wizards have gotten 4 of their first 5 shots to go since the break. Pass to Avdija. Now here's Wright from deep. And his 5th basket. Now 5 for 8. Looking comfortable out there.
Now that is huge when Wright is connecting from deep. It really spreads the floor for him and his teammates.
Outside heel. The steal. Here's Avdija, guarded by Hield. And there's a 3-second violation.
We've seen more than a few miscues from them tonight.
And I tell you what, more brain neutral plays like that one, and they'll have a hole deeper than the one they're already in. TJ McConnell.
Now Halliburton. He's got 14. Shoots over Beal. And once again, off the mark by Indiana. And Washington with possession. They're on an 11-2 run.
Boy, you look at Porzingis, and for a bigger guy, he's really agile, which I think puts defenders in difficult spots when they're trying to guard them.
All right, a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Pacers.
You know, this is an example of why conditioning can be so important. I mean, it can be critical. They continue to sprint the floor, and there's no let-up in sight.
And another note, how about the way they've cashed in off turnovers, taking advantage when given the extra opportunity?
And, you know, when healthy, Porzingis is a problem, man. I mean, this guy is so hard to match up against because of his skill and his size.
Both free throws good from Porzingis.
Free throw shooting is about mechanics, confidence, and your mental approach. He's locked in from there most every night.
And the Pacers call time here. And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Thanks, B.A. Bradley Beal played for Coach Greg Popovich with the U.S. national team. And Pop said, quote, he's hard to keep up with. His balance and movement are very impressive. He stops on a dime, can pull up and shoot. That, along with his excellent footwork, are the most impressive things for me. Brian?
Yeah, great breakdown there, Allie. Thank you. out left to the wing. McConnell outside. Heald passes to Halliburton. And once again, off the mark by Indiana. The Wizards have got 5 of 6 shots to fall so far in the third. Beal. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Halliburton.
A great read to get a hand in there and disrupt the play.
And, you know, even though they didn't come up with the steal, that's still a nice defensive play.
Morris, he's checked in for Bradley Beal. And Washington with possession. They've got a 13-2 run going. 6 on the shot clock. Morris can't hit. The Pacers have gotten just 25% of their shots to fall since the half. 2 for 8. McConnell from outside. Rebounded by Kuzma. Kuzma's got 5 rebounds in the game. Pass to Wright. Here's Avdija. Launches it. It's rebounded by Bataze.
Certainly not the kind of night he was looking for at the offensive end, and it's had a ripple effect on the team.
He didn't have his feet planted.
Yeah, and I like this call because you want the ref in that situation. If there's any doubt, err on the side of giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player. That should have been a block, and it was.
Outside heel. Shot clock at 6. Back to McConnell. Knocks it loose. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D.
Washington ball.
So it's Washington now. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Pass to Morris. Here's Avdija. Lets a 3 fly. And again, Washington, no good.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
And once again, off the mark by Indiana. Here's Washington now. They've got a 13-2 run going. They get the rebound. Indiana's gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the third. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2. Kristaps Porzingis picks one up.
When you talk about the best shooters in the NBA, Buddy Hield has to be in the conversation.
Buddy Hield. 2 shots.
2 shots. Last on the first.
No good on the free throw. So for the Wizards, Gafford, he's checked in for Kristaps Porzingis. Hachimura comes in for Kuzma. And it's Barton in for Avdija. He hits the second from the line. Washington's gone, only 1 of 3 from deep here in the third. Morris down low. He's marked by McConnell. Gafford passes to Morris. 6 to shoot. Here's Barton. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
First personal foul.
And you can't try to rough up Barton. You can't get too physical with him. He's very good at using his body against yours to draw fouls.
Shooting 2.
That free throw, good from Barton.
Yeah, I've got mad respect for the way Barton carries himself. I mean, he's a terrific teammate. He does everything he can to impact winning.
Brissett's checked in for Indiana.
That misses, so he splits the free throws. Indiana has gone 5 of 10 from beyond the three-point line in this game. Pass to Bataze. Here's Brissett. Halliburton left side. That one falls. Halliburton's got 6 in the quarter.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
If it's working, keep working it. That's what I say. Keep the pressure on.
Right, the pass to Barton. Here's Hachimura. And a good offensive board. And he gets the bucket.
They're doing the job on both ends, getting stops and attacking offensively.
And, you know, it's taken a big run, but they were able to get back into this one. Very impressive. No quitting these guys.
And the Pacers call time here.
Let's find those fans. Show some love and clap your hands. Here they are, your Indiana Pacers. Time for your Indiana Pacers, everyone. Let's get excited.
Here. Duarte's checked in.
Duarte.
Here's Halliburton. 16 points for him. Pass to Duarte. The ball's knocked loose, and it's out of bounds to Indiana.
Indiana ball.
Against Halliburton. Pass to Duarte. 4 on the clock. From deep.
His offensive output just isn't there tonight, but his teammates have found a way to pick up a slack.
Halliburton, the pass to Jackson. Bataze down low, work it on Gafford, and Bataze gets it to go.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Right outside. Goes up at the elbow. Oh, nice shot by Morris. Morris has got 11 points.
Boy, he's really been dominant in this one. Unfortunately, he hasn't had much help.
Back to Halliburton. Ooh, Morris with a steal. And a fast break now for the Wizards. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line.
Personal foul. Fourth team foul. Shooting for Washington. Will Barton taking 2 shots.
That free throw, good from Barton. Heels checked in for Indiana. Second free throw, no good.
Oh, love the intensity in which they're hitting the boards.
Guys, that's been the key to their lead. I mean, simply put, the effort they've displayed on the glass has been the difference.
Here's Washington now. They're on a 19-7 run. Pass to Wright. Back to Barton. Wright outside. Down to 5 on the shot clock.
Here's Morris. And the jumper falls for him. Morris has gotten four this quarter. Indiana leading. Here's Duarte, guarded by Morris. Halliburton, the pass to Heald. That's good. And Halliburton gets the assist. Halliburton's got four assists in the game. Martin outside. Back to Morris. To the left wing. Martin outside. Shot clock at six. Back to Gafford.
2 minutes remaining.
Pass to Barton. From deep three-point range. With the clock winding down. And it's slammed in by Achimura.
Grabs the board and goes right in for the putback. I love it, B.A.
Yeah, wanted to close the gap. Makes sense to get aggressive on the glass here.
Well, I don't think it would be a bad idea, but I mean, they could use all the second chance points they can get.
Here's Bataze. Here's Duarte from deep. Achimura with a rebound. Achimura's got four rebounds now. Morris outside. Pass to Gafford. Back to Morris. Ooh, making his presence felt here. He's now 6 for 9 in this game.
He's bringing a lot of energy to this offense, not letting the scoreboard discourage him right now.
Boy, I tell you what, the hole would be a lot deeper if he wasn't being as efficient as he's been so far.
Here's Bataze. He's guarded by Gafford. It's stolen by Wright. Morris against Halliburton. Back to Morris. Got a piece of it. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. So it's Washington now. Achimura, the pass to Morris. On the wing, Barton. Plenty of space. They get it back. Achimura. And the shot goes. Achimura's got six.
I love his tenacity. Extra possessions, second chance points. That's winning basketball.
Heald against Barton. Heald up top. Shoots over Barton. Off target with the shot. And we've reached the end of the third. It's the Pacers. They're up by four. And time for a short break. Stay right there. The fourth quarter is coming up next. Rick Carlisle had some advice for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Guys, we're going to struggle guard movement, but if we dribble, 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 they got one situation to play. It's too easy. All right?
More ball movement. That's what Coach Carlisle is asking for.
Exactly. I mean, when you over dribble, you're letting the defense off the hook. The more you move the ball, the more it tires out the defense.
And with three quarters behind us, we'll start the fourth in what is still anybody's ball game. Fourth quarter on the court for the Wizards. In the middle, it's Porzingis with Kuzma by his side. Will Barton is out there with Bradley Beal, and it's Avdija in at the three. Halliburton against Beal. Pass to Heald. Five to shoot. Offensive rebound, Pacers. Second shot opportunity, and all around the rim that time before dropping. Heald's got 36 points.
Well, he's demanding the ball. He wants it, and he's coming through. I mean, you can see why his teammates trust him down the stretch, guys.
Barton outside. No luck on that one, so Indiana will take it the other way. Their biggest lead of the game is 21. Pass to Halliburton. Barton against Heald. And here's Turner.
inside the arc, and the three-pointer goes. And now a seven-point Indiana lead.
Really like it when Turner squares up from outside because he's got a sweet stroke, and because of his size, hard for defenders to get to the shot, and it also stretches the floor, which is good for his team.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
More than just a score, Hield moves the ball well, especially when his guys are open.
Beal, the pass to Porzingis. Back to Beal. The three. Pacers with a rebound. Just under 2.5 minutes gone by now in the final quarter. Here's Hield. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
Third personal foul.
Kristaps Porzingis picks one up.
Yeah, really left him no choice there. I mean, he had to foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
At the line for the Pacers, Buddy Hield. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Hield hits them both. For Washington, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field in this final quarter. Pass to Barton. Beal outside. It's Abdia on the wing. Porzingis in the post. Guarded by Hield, and that one's good. Porzingis.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
Second team foul. At the line for Indiana, Buddy Hield. Two shots.
First one falls for him. Hield hits them both. Washington has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Now a timeout called by Washington. Boy, Buddy Hield displaying all his skills today.
He's getting loose and doing work. They want to talk this over and find some answers.
Youth Dance Team. Please give a big round.
The Wizards making a switch here. Wright's checked in. All right, let's get a report from Allie.
I was able to listen in on what Wes Unseld Jr. had to say to his team. He said to them, quote, "We've worked hard to come back. We have them on the ropes, but we have yet to land the knockout blow. We'll see if they can. Back to you."
All right, Allie, thanks once again. It's deflected. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Back to Avdija. Beal against Heald. And here's Wright from the arc. Oh, he drains it. His sixth make and 9 tries so far.
He's come out here in the second half and done a nice job moving, getting good looks, and finding his range.
Now here's Heald. Here's the three. Connects from downtown.
This is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
Out to Beal. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Second personal foul.
I like when Beal looks to score inside because it forces the D to get physical with him.
Bradley Beal, two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Beal drops them both. Halliburton with the ball. Outside Heald. Pass to Smith. Here's Duarte. Hounded by Beal. It's stolen by Kuzma. And that one goes. He's shooting 5 of 9 in this one.
Well, that's exactly the kind of strength Kuzma has to show, guys. I mean, take that contact, expect it, and still be able to convert. You've got to do that at this level.
Now Turner, defended by Porzingis. Turner passes to Halliburton. No good on the triple.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Here's Wright. That one's in there on the nice assist from Beal. Beal's got his third assist of the night.
Showing off tremendous handles, right, confusing the defenders, and scoring the basketball, too.
Heald passes to Smith. Here's Duarte. Pass to Halliburton. 5 on the clock. And it's Miles Turner with the foul. That's his third foul so far. And the basket by Halliburton.
Halliburton's length, really an asset on that play.
From Duarte.
Washington has gone 1 for 3 in the fourth quarter from range. Here's Avdija. With the 7-footer. And he hits the jump shot.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's 3 straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Right against Halliburton. Oh, and he blocks it off the glass. Wow.
Boy, he's got such length at 6'5 in the backcourt. Perhaps surprised the shooter there and came up with the block.
It's winning time, and that's a winning play.
Pass to Duarte. Now here's Heald. And here's Turner. Let's it fly. And it's good as he snugs it right through the net. Turner's got 5 points in the quarter.
Man, I love watching Turner pull up for the jumper. Always helps to have a bigger guy who can shoot the ball.
Pass to Porzingis. Beal outside. Right with the ball to tie it up. And the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Smith's got four rebounds now. Here's Duarte, pounded by Beal. Takes one from 10 feet. Duarte's shot is good. Now it's a 5-point Pacer lead.
Encouraging signs for him after starting the game poorly. He's picked it up here in the second half.
Back to right. Kuzma, right side. Counted from distance.
Tell you what, guys, he seems to improve with every game. I mean, Kuzma continues to hone his catch and shoot game.
Pass to Duarte. Now healed. Halliburton on the wing. Kept alive. Turner. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. And the Pacers lead by four.
Boy, tough trying to match Turner's intensity. I mean, once he's committed to scoring the ball, you're not stopping him.
Over to the wing. For three, Porzingis. The rebound by Turner. Turner's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Pass to Halliburton. Outside heel. Fires from deep. Rebound by the Wizards. Kuzma's got six rebounds in the game. Here's Beal. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a 3-point play.
At the line for the Wizards, Bradley Beal. Shooting one.
One shot.
Pacers have gotten 8 of 14 shots to drop so far here in the fourth quarter. Back to Halliburton. And it's going to be a three-second call.
You know, guys, sometimes that just happens, but don't like to see it when the game is this close.
Washington has gone 2 of 6 so far in the fourth. Here's Avdija, guarded by Hield. Beal outside. Marked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call. Indiana leading. Outside Hield. Pass to Duarte. Halliburton with the ball. Six on the shot clock. Back to Duarte. Lets it go from deep. They get it again. And there's contact and a whistle. So he's got two shots coming up.
Second personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for the Pacers, Jalen Smith, two shots.
The first free throw is good. And he makes both free throws. Washington trailing. Beal with it. Halliburton picks him up. Right, the pass to Beal. Porzingis with it. Pass to Kuzma. The shot that time, not on target. Ooh, excellent D there from Turner. Here's Duarte, pounded by Beal.
Heald with the ball.
2 minutes remaining.
Clock at six.
2 minutes.
Here's Halliburton. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Halliburton's got 4 points this quarter.
What a big-time play by Tyrese Halliburton. Simply putting his team on his back.
Beal, the pass to Kuzma. And here's Wright. Ooh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now. And they'll give that one to Miles Turner.
Shooting for Washington. The long right. At the line for two.
Drops the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just four.
Well, you know, you've got to really appreciate DeLon Wright's relentless desire to get better. I mean, this guy is constantly trying to hone his craft.
He's off on the free throw, unable to get the second one to drop.
Just a tough miss at the line. They're down two baskets now.
Kuzma against Heald. Here's Turner. Good work there as it goes. Turner's got 9 points here in the second half.
Tossing around that 250 lbs. Turner going right through the contact.
And the basket by Beal.
And bam! I mean, coaches love Beal late in the game. He's got long range, great off the bounce, a true star in the league.
Left side Heald. And the ball out of play. The Wizards will have it. Morris, he's checked in for Wright. Now a timeout called by Washington. They're down by four. 1 minute left in the fourth quarter. Take a look at the New Balance player of the game, DeLon Wright.
Well, he made the defense look absolutely helpless because whatever they tried to do, he had a counter for it. You could see their frustration mounting, and that led to his confidence growing throughout the ball game.
Here's Beal. 55 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Oh, and Turner with a block.
Man, the defense of Turner is astounding. I mean, he positioned himself well to come up with a lot of blocks.
Right side Heald. Pass to Duarte. Fires the three. Rebounded by Kuzma.
You know, brick after brick after brick. I mean, that's been the story for him this quarter. I mean, he's got to brain it in down the stretch here.
Buddy Hield, second personal foul, fourth team foul. At the line for the Wizards, Kyle Kuzma, two shots.
First of two, no good. A heartbreaker.
Kyle Kuzma is a guy who burst on the scene during his rookie year and is a fun player to watch. He's a guy that really has an outstanding all-around game.
Damn, no luck at the stripe this time. Second one won't fall.
Boy, that's a rebounding clinic right there. He boxed out and then went up aggressively and strong for it.
And now we've got an intentional foul.
15 fouls.
Good on the first, and that puts him up five. And so he drops them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
He doesn't waste a chance to pad their lead. It's been some solid free throw shooting.
Timeout called, the Wizards. They trail by six. 24 seconds left in the fourth.
Here you go. Everyone.
24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Morris. Pacers with a rebound. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Third personal foul. Team is in the penalty. At the line for Indiana, Tyrese Halliburton. Two shots.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. So he can't get either to fall. Now Morris. Beal finds Porzingis. Off target with the three. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Fourth personal foul. At the line. For Indiana, Tyrese Halliburton, two shots.
Two.
He gets the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. Second one is good, getting both at the line, and it's an 8-point ball game.
Morris for three. Misses. And so it's Indiana winning this one. A clean win, and one where they clearly show better energy.
Yeah, so true. They put on a show here at home. And I really think they had that extra swagger and confidence, too.
Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Yeah, I'm here with Miles Turner. And Miles, they made a run there in the second half. What was key in closing out this win?
Just staying the course. Every team makes its run, so you got to know that. Just got to stay the course. And that's really what it was. You know, every team makes their run. They're going to get some good looks, and they're going to be a team.
You could tell you guys were not affected by their run. Congrats on the win, Miles.
All right, Allie, good stuff there. Thanks for that. And that'll do it for this inaugural game of the NBA season. For Clark Kellogg, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson. So long, everybody.